personal between me, and I'm going to do you some serious harm, you big stiff idiot. Okay.
The Untouchable True School Sports Empire proudly presents Something the Boxing Game's Been Missing. Hey, what's going on? It's your boy BT, and I came here to talk some boxing with the thousands of True School Sports subscribers. Now, as you guys know, I've said recently that I wanted to make it a point to really start covering the South Florida boxing scene, make that a focal point of the channel as it once was, because I've gotten away from it over the last year and some change. And that's what we're doing here on True School Sports. And when I say the South Florida boxing scene, I don't just mean the South Florida born and bred fighters. There is a whole other part. There are so many worlds within the South Florida boxing scene that need to be covered. And one of the areas and one of the gyms that I really want to focus on covering is Warriors Boxing Gym, one of my favorite gyms in South Florida, because I feel like it's a unique gym. You know, it's a gym that features a lot of, foreign talent, mostly residing out of Uzbekistan and the Central Asian countries. And this is a gym that I really feel like is going to have a world champion or two in the not-so-distant future. Obviously, the one that I rate the highest is Otar Aronosian, who's ranked number 3 in WBA in the super featherweight division. He maybe do a title shot against Hector Luis Garcia sooner rather than later. But the other fighter, and that's what this video is about, that I really rate highly, that I think could be a world champion within the next year or so, is a fighter by the name of Otabek Kholmatov. And you know, a lot of you guys may have not heard that name because it's not a name that's been pushed by the promoters or anything like that. But if you study boxing rankings, right, if you guys know your boxing rankings, if you really know the contenders in each weight class, the high-level contenders in each weight class, you would know that this guy right here, Otabek Kholmatov, he's significant because he may just be due a world title shot himself very soon. Right now, as it stands, Otabek Kholmatov is ranked number 2 in the WBA featherweight rankings. And it's been reported and rumored that, you know, his next fight could come against number 1 contender in the undefeated 33-0-1 fighter from the UK, Thomas Patrick Ward. So that'd be a good fight if it comes off. It hasn't been announced officially, but there's a lot of speculation that that fight will be for the final eliminator spot. So make note of that. But who is this Otabek Kholmatov, and why is BT talking about him now? Otabek, I would say, from just going to the gym and watching him train and spar a couple times, very disciplined fighter. He's well known and well renowned all around South Florida for being a guy that's always in shape. They call him Bruce Lee because he kind of looks like Bruce Lee, and he's shredded like Bruce Lee. I mean, the guy, he's always on Hollywood Beach running, and this guy can run for miles. So he's very, very in great shape. He comes into the professionals as a well-schooled fighter. You know, a lot of amateur fights. He was the, he was 2016 gold medalist in the Asia Championships. Won the bronze in the 2017 World Youth Championships, I believe, or the World Championships. I'm not sure if it's the World Youth or the World Championships, but decorated, accomplished things in the amateurs. He's trained and guided by under the watchful eye of former Uzbekistan Olympian, heavyweight, and former professional fighter as well, Timur Abrakimov, good friend of the channel. And so he's in good hands. I like Otabek. From watching him spar, and you guys can go see his sparring sessions, there's a couple sparring sessions on this channel of Otabek, one against Jordan Murphy and the other against Lazaro Medina, two talented fighters. Otabek's a hard-punching southpaw. He's very well conditioned, a hard-punching southpaw on both hands. He's the kind of guy that if you allow him to sit there and plant his feet and go to the body on you, he will really, really have a big chance of hurting you. And I've seen him do it plenty of times, not those sparring sessions, but I've seen other sparring sessions where I recorded him not sparring against those guys per se, but other guys in South Florida. And I've seen Otabek absolutely beat people in the gym up to a bloody pulp. So this guy is a really good fighter. This guy is the real deal. This guy, I think, has a great chance to become, world champion. And he's in prime position to, hopefully sooner than rather than later, fight for a world title. I mean, he only has 10 professional fights. He's 10-0 with 9 knockouts. His last fight, he took on a very, very tough opponent in 14. And previously, on being 14-0, Adrianek Gregorian. And he beat him. I mean, I thought he beat him. It was a tough competitive fight where some resistance was offered to him from, the Russian fighter. I mean, the guy is a shorter fighter than Otabek. Otabek, you got to understand, too, Otabek is a 5'7" for this weight class, which is a good size for this weight class. very long, rangy. So this guy was a smaller fighter. He had a punch down. And Andres Gregorian was a guy that really didn't care. I mean, if you go back and you watch the weigh-in, you know, he literally grabbed Otabek by the neck and he was ready for all the smoke. So he's shown that he could perform in against a fighter who will give him some rounds. I think the fight was good for him to get those rounds, because if you look at his career so far, that was the only fight he's had so far where he's gone past the fourth round. So he showed he can go the distance. Ideally, it'd be nice to see him go the distance again, or at least go some rounds. And I really hope for his sake he gets that Thomas Ward fight, because I've seen Thomas Ward fight before. I saw Thomas Ward fight on Showbox years ago when he fought Jesse Angel Hernandez for the NABA bantamweight title. And you know, good slick boxer, got very good footwork and knows his way around the ring, knows how to move around the ring. So it's a fight where I think Otabek's craft and his patience will be tested. Because, like I said, Ward's a 34-fight veteran, and he's hungry himself to win a title. Otabek would have in his favor going from the fact that Thomas Ward really doesn't really punch all that hard. I mean, he's got 5 knockouts in 34 fights, so his record tells you he's not a hard puncher. And on top of that, you know, I've watched him fight before, so I know he's not like Michael McKinson, where he's kind of like a physically strong guy. He's not like incredibly physically strong, but he's a very well-schooled technical boxer. So I feel like Otabek could beat him. And then if he could beat him, then you're looking at Otabek possibly fighting, you know, right now as it stands, where is he? Right now as it stands, you got the whole situation in the WBA with, you know, Leo Santa Cruz and Lee Woods. Maybe he fights one of those guys for a title. Maybe he comes to the back door and he winds up being a factor in this division sooner rather than later. But, yeah, Otabek, I mean, he's a really hardworking fighter. There's a whole lot to like with him. You know, he's been in there and he's sparred with the likes of Javante Davis. He helped Tank get ready and do some sparring back in, you know when Tank did his camp for Isak Cruz last year, because Tank did do a lot of his camp here for the Isak Cruz fight down there at Carter Park at Contender's Boxing Gym. So he did spar him once. And he's been getting a lot of great work. So yeah, I want y'all to look out for this man. You know, Otabek Kholmatov, you know, from Uzbekistan, the next in a long list of top fighters coming out of the country, Uzbekistan. You know, I don't know what it is in the water out there in Uzbekistan, but, you know, whatever it is, I want some, because they damn sure know how to produce some good fighters, some killers. So yeah, I'll look out for them, and we'll definitely be covering Otabek as he moves forward in his boxing career. So yeah, leave your comments down below. Make sure you guys take time to subscribe. And like I say in every single one of these videos, you can love me or you can hate me, but I'm just a kid from Daniel. So until next time, take your eyes.
Just like Mayweather's uncle would say, a lot of people don't know shit about boxing. You know, you do. You've done
Thank
it.
Thank you.
You about the only smart guy that I know, bro. Nobody knows shit about boxing.
I appreciate it, man.
I'm gonna say, man, make sure to follow True School Sports, always covering boxing at the highest level, man, and make sure to subscribe to his YouTube channel. Follow him on Instagram at Just a Kid from Danny as well.
Thank you for watching True School Sports.
No, follow this kid. Oh. You know, he's a true, you know, it's a young, true, passionate person who follows boxing. He wakes up thinking about boxing and he goes to sleep thinking about boxing. So
this is true.
He's a good kid, good man, and looking forward to seeing him everywhere in the boxing world.
Hey man, if you ain't subscribed to True School Sports, you fucking up, man. Make sure you subscribe, bro.
Fucking up big time.
Make sure, man.